you know, and a lot of people in this room. By show of hands or by making some noise, how many of y'all participated in Hip Hop Action Day? The ones that's quiet, you can make it up to me on Monday. But we have a special guest in the house. She came here 20 years ago off the Greyhound from Chicago. Some of y'all might know her from the Fox 9 News. And some of y'all might know her from her recent decision to put in her candidacy to be our next Lieutenant Governor of the great state of Minnesota. So Varsity Theater, if y'all could please give it up for Mrs. Robyn Robinson.
Check
the tango, check the ground.
You can cut around that, cut around that one, yep.
I can keep it going, come on. Yeah, makes me comfortable.
And I want to thank Cable and AT Productions for letting us sit up here on the stage for a minute. How y'all doing tonight?
Good.
You know, I just feel really good about the response that was to Hip Hop Action Day, and I got to go out with some of you and knock on some doors and talk to people and convince them why they need to get up and vote. And it made me feel really good because 20 years, it's an amazing thing to see some of the young people that I first interviewed when they were almost in their teens, when they were on Channel 9, you know, and see them grow up to be such great individuals, such great human beings, besides such wonderful artists, but just great human beings, just good people. And it just makes you feel so good that you connect with people in such a way that they open up their heart and their home and everything that we're thinking at a really young age, you know, when they had no reason to trust anybody, especially sort of with a TV camera working for a TV station. But, you know, I have so much love for this community and so much music was going on here. And I just wanted everybody to know about it. But I also want everybody to know the people behind the music. This town has really, really blessed me with knowing some amazing individuals, you know, all throughout all the arts in this community. And I just feel rich and I feel incredibly blessed and just really happy that, you know, Matt and Entenza saw that all I've ever wanted to do is be a good human being. You know, and want to give back to a community that's given me so much.
That's right.
And honest to God, I came here with no job. And I knew one person, and that was it. And all I ever did was try to have a sincere and honest message in everything I ever tried to do, and that was to represent a community that I grew up in, that looked like me, that had the same experiences as me, and oftentimes never heard from, unless, you know, Jerry's flash, and then a news camera's there, and that's just about it. And good things, kind of, you know, talked about, but, you know, not often. And I was always taught that, you know, you have to keep your foot wedged in the door for other people to come by and make a noise, too. And I think I did that with Channel 9. I tried really hard to, I really did.
Yeah, you did.
And so, all I wanted to do was just make sure that somebody could come behind me and tell our truth and tell our story. You know, and I just hope that I get the opportunity to represent you on a grander scale. You know, TV is one thing, but to represent a community that has always embraced you is another thing, you know. And to do it on a scale that is meaningful, where I provide a better education for many of the kids, of these young kids that I grew up in, you know, and make sure that they're not turned into a statistic, you know? Make sure there's some viable money there so you can make a living and be an artist and not have to go work two jobs, you know? And then for our parents, I don't ever want my mother to have to make a choice between a pill and a meal, ever. A lot of work to be done, and you know, it's the kind of work that none of us really want to do, you know, because it means getting up and stop watching True Blood and stop playing Madden, and we have to do something, you know. We got a $6 billion budget deficit. I'm not going to get into politics too much, and we got a big problem. And unless we count on each other, it is not going to change around. It's going to be doing some things we may not like to do, but we got to get them done. So that said, let me reflect on why I'm here. I'm here because we watched for 30 plus years how people with nothing can create a nation and a movement around the world. You know, the phrase two turntables and a microphone is not to be taken lightly. Again, that's when there's no money for schools and arts programs are cut, and some child takes their mother's record and makes new music.
Yeah, right.
New music that the world can. Yeah. Let's not be taken lightly. So now we see hip hop grow up, and hip hop has kids, and hip hop has a job,
yeah.
And maybe a divorce. Yeah. One thing holds true: hip hop is a nation, it is a movement, it is not a lifestyle, it is a life. Yeah. And hip hop votes. And that's why I'm asking you all to just get out on Tuesday. You may not like me, you may not like what I have to say, and it doesn't matter. All you gotta do is fill up your responsibility and vote.
That's right.
And vote.
Yeah.
Thank you.
That's it. Yeah! Woo, 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 woo. Oh, yeah!
Y'all give it up for Robyn.